When you upgrade from iMovie to Final Cut Pro, you get a host of new tools and features. All these new tools and features are very useful, but some are more so than others. The ability to add a mask to your video clip is one of the most useful features you don't normally get in free software. Today, we're going to take a look at using a mask tool in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. Before I go any further, if you haven't yet, scroll down and hit that small red subscribe button below. This way you'll get to see all my videos when they come out, at least one every week. Go ahead, I'll wait. Okay, now that that's done, what exactly is a mask and what does it do? Adding a mask to a video clip adds an area of transparency to part of the image. When there's no clip layered below the mask, this area will show up as black. When there is a clip or an image under a mask clip, this clip will be visible through the transparent part of the mask. This can be used for layering clips, highlighting parts of video, adding effects to only specific parts of the image, and so on. Let's take a look at the shape mask. A shape mask allows you to quickly create a mask in any shape, from an ellipse to a rectangle. To apply a shape mask to your clip, open the effects browser and scroll down to the masks category. Select the shape mask and drag and drop it over your clip. The area inside the mask remains the same, and everything outside the mask becomes transparent. Because there is no clip under a timeline clip, this area appears as black. If we were to add a clip underneath, that clip would show through in the areas outside the mask. Let's press Command-Z to undo that. When you apply the shape mask, its on-screen controls appear in the viewer, and the adjustment parameters appear in the effects section of the inspector. You can use either the on-screen controls or the adjustment parameters in the inspector to adjust the shape of your mask as needed. Let's take a look at adjusting the mask using the on-screen controls. To reposition your mask, click and drag the white circle inside the mask. Click and drag the green handle connected to the white circle to rotate your mask. The four green dots on the sides of the mask are used to adjust the shape's width or height. Clicking and dragging these will adjust the shape's opposite sides. You can also hold down the Option key while dragging to adjust only one side, or if you hold down the Shift key while dragging, all four sides will be adjusted proportionately. To adjust the curvature of the mask, click and drag the white control handle in the top left corner. Dragging it to one extreme will give you a perfect rectangle, while dragging it to the opposite extreme will give you an oval or a perfect circle. To control the edge softness, click and drag the outer circle. Dragging the outer circle close to the inner circle will give you a hard edge, while dragging the outer circle away from the inner circle will soften the edge and give you a more gradual transition. All these controls are also available in the inspector, along with a couple of additional controls. Selecting the Invert Mask checkbox will reverse your mask, making the inside transparent. Also, clicking the Convert to Points button will convert your mask shape to control points, which we'll talk about in one of my upcoming videos. So, now that we know how to apply a mask and how to make all the adjustments, let's see how we can use a shape mask to highlight our subject in our clip. First thing we need to do is duplicate our clip. Hold down the Option key and drag up the clip to make a copy of it. Next, apply the shape mask and resize it to fit the subject in the clip. Select the bottom clip, and in the color correction section of the inspector, bring down the global saturation, bring down the highlight exposure, and bump up the shadows just to flatten out the image a little. Next, select the top clip again and bring up the global saturation a bit to make our subject pop. Let's take a look at our image before and after. This was just a simple example of how to use a mask in Final Cut Pro. Next week, we'll take a look at some of the more complex masking controls by using the Draw Mask effect. If you haven't yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. And feel free to ask any questions you may have in the comments below, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. So, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you back next week.